Hookshot really doesn't have much range, do you?
This one doesn't, no.
It is rad, though.
Yeah.
Nice.
More games should have something like a hookshot.
Mm.
Honestly, the Forest Temple is one of my favorite ones in this game.
There's a great remix of the Forest Temple theme that I'll send you after we finish recording, Roxy.
Oh, cool.
It's okay, a lyric one.
Nice, because I think like the design is just so out there.
Yeah.
It really just feels different from what you've done before in the game.
Yeah, it's a good transition spot. And it's a great way of highlighting that in the adult time, the temples do make more sense.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, well, they made sense in kid time as well, more than usual, but they were still kind of dungeony, cave, going through a tree. But this is just an old manor house in the Lost Woods.
Yeah, which I've always wondered, like, why?
Yeah.
Especially because if this is the sacred meadow, if this is supposed to be where,
the way the Sage of Forest is linked?
Yeah. Not just that, I was gonna say, because I know the Temple of Time was the doorway to the Sacred Realm, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Which is where the Triforce was housed. But then, like, I'm trying to remember, what did the Sacred Meadow have to do with that? Because I think in other games, the Sacred Meadow is... Or something similar to the Sacred Meadow is, like, where the Master Sword is, or...
In Link of the Past, kind of, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So, but there is kind of a sign that in, that things are, that at some point the Master Sword gets moved, so it does have some kind of association with that, possibly.
Yeah, okay.
So how do you beat these Ruguru?
You have to wait for them to swim.
When they strike you? Yeah.
Yep.
There's a pause that you're supposed to jump in and attack them.
So you avoid one pause and wait for the other. You're not going to do anything for that one, are you, Roxy?
No.
I was trying to think of a good pause pun.
Well, I mean, we did all just pause when Adrian said that, so... It was itself.
So, but we are much better at dealing with them than we were as a kid. We could just one-shot them with the Master Sword now.
Same as the Sculpture left, eh?
Yep.
Master Sword, Master Sword.
Yep.
Hookshot for Master Race. Apparently.
No.
Let's not
do some Master Race stuff in this time and age.
No, let's not yet.
So those were the Poe sisters. Those four ghosts there, the colorful ones. They ran off and closed off the passage down below. So we will have to track them down.
Makes sense.
They're going to be the mini-bosses of this dungeon. So this is the hub of the manor. We're going to go ahead and go straight across to start. And I'm going to deal with this quickly, this enemy, but I did hear a little bit of scratching before I left through that door.
Boy.
That is a bubble. You might remember them from Link to the Past, the bouncing pink skulls. This is the 3D version. Fortunately, you can't change them into a fairy in this game.
Oh. At least they're easier to deal with.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you don't attack them fast enough, they can reignite.
Yep. And I'm sure we'll see that at some point, knowing me.
So many sculptures.
Yeah. And the cool thing with the hookshot is that, like, even though you would have used the boomerang when you were a kid to retrieve them, the hookshot does the same thing.
Yep. You can just stick with a single weapon.
Was an interesting rising animation.
Yeah?
It should have went from horizontal to vertical.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, they're dodgy skeletons.
Well, really, aren't all skeletons a little dodgy?
Does that mean that we also are dodgy?
Are we skeletons?
We have skeletons inside us, man.
Don't tell me that. I'm gonna have nightmares tonight.
Inside every good man is a dodgy skeleton waiting to kill.
No, it's actually kind of funny when you think about it that, like, we are basically meat puppets for our brain, which is hiding inside a skeleton.
So that is an interesting way to think about it.
And then, of course, like, babies are piloting a fleshy mecha.
So I'm trying to be a little bit fancier with the second one, and it's not entirely paying off. But I didn't die, and that's the important thing.
I think you can also bomb them?
I believe so. I might show that off next time. But that is a Stealthos. Just as jumpy as they were in Link to the Past, and much more annoying to deal with. And that is what we would turn into if we spent too long in the Lost Woods. Meat would just slough right off our body.
Goodbye, meat puppet. Hello, skeleton.
Oh, he left behind a fairy. That's nice of him.
What I... very kind. What I want to know is, why do all skeletons have, like, glowing little fire eyes?
Well, they gotta have something to see.
Yeah, but is it, like, a reference to corpse lights, or... like, where did that come from?
I think it's supposed to, like, refer to the fact that they used to be humans. They used to be people.
Make it a little bit less inhuman by giving them something that, other than empty sockets.
That, or, like, I was interpreting more as, like, the fire in their sockets is, like, the remnant of their soul kind of thing.
Because, you know, Jason the Argonauts is always, like, the sort of the earliest... skeletons as villains sort of thing.
Oh, you mean the stop motion movie with the...
Yeah.
I forget his name. Ray something or other. The iconic iconic claymation skeleton guy.
Yeah. Because those skeletons are just normal skeletons. They don't have like any fire eyes or anything like that.
Yeah.
But most sort of skeletons nowadays and video games and like depiction of things have like some sort of corpse light eyes.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good point. So we've got a couple of keys.
I actually think it's scarier when they don't have eyes, like any light in them whatsoever, because you can't tell where they're looking.
It's like sunglasses, you can't trust them.
Yeah, like with the lights, it kind of makes them look a little more human.
Yeah.
Like people, but sans eyes, it's like, nope, never mind, terrifying. It's like an Undertale.
I like sans's eyes.
But that's what I'm saying. It's like in Undertale when Sans doesn't have that, like, that iris, that glow.
Mm-hmm.
And when he's serious, and you're like, oh shit, never mind.
Yeah, definitely. So I think next bubble I am just gonna let sit so that we can see it rise back up. So there are. Notice, by the way, the Gerudo symbol again. You know, I wonder if it's not a connection to puzzles. I wonder if they're just, like, stonemasons or something.
I think that would make a lot of sense when you visit the Gerudo base at some point.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wish the games, like, even if they didn't touch upon it in-game. Like, you know how Elder Scrolls and, like, Mass Effect, they're in-game text?
Like, the encyclopedias?
Like encyclopedias or like little tidbits of history where you can kind of figure out like, oh, so this happened or that kind of thing. But since Legend of Zelda just never does that, there's a lot that we speculate about.
Yeah. Well, I mentioned this before, but keep in mind that Miyamoto doesn't care about
the plot. Doesn't care, and it kills me.
Or lore, or world building. It's all gameplay for him.
Why?
Well, I mean, it's worked out well for him. He's had a little bit of success with that model.
just a tad.
So we pulled the block around and got access to up here. Where we have the similar thing. This one, though, is a little trickier because we can't pull it all the way out from up here. But there's a ladder left behind where the blue block was. I know I'm going a little bit ahead of you guys, by the way, but that's one of the troubles with doing the stream. So, that lets us get around to the other side of the block and push the rest of the way forward. Someday I should find a better way of screen sharing. Never had any luck with that, though.
There's always some measure of latency.
Yeah. Especially when it's a transatlantic cooperation. So that's been pushed, that's been pulled out, but we still need a way to get around to push it in the right direction.
Do we need to pull it this way so we can then get like past it and then push it the other way? Pull it the other way?
Well, it needs to be flush with the other side to pull it in either direction, but I can try something like that. Oh, never mind. I was just an idiot.
Oh no.
You'll see shortly. It'll come any second now.
Oh. Yeah.
Alright, so yeah, I might be cutting out a little of that. Okay, we're up.
We're good at puzzles, we square.
Yeah. Well, let's let this jump around a little bit. Little bat skull. And not only does it reignite, but it's angry when it does. Shoots right towards you. And you don't actually have to wait for it to unflame, to hookshot it. It's a little bit tricky. Oh, I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself here. Ooh. So this twisted corridor, we will want to visit that later.
I love this corridor.
Just shoot the eye above the door.
That's part of it. But not quite yet.
Oh, we need arrows to shoot the doors.
Yep. So we're going to do a little bit more hub exploration before we check out that corridor. Ah, here we go. And this is how you're supposed to know how to deal with this, what Navi is saying right now.
Thank you.
And past there, we get into this nice open-air corridor. Or courtyard, I mean. This is a really nice house.
Hmm. Aside from the Deku Baba, this is actually really nice, sort of like outside bit.
Yeah.
It's also huge as fuck, damn. It's real hard to see the sculptures.
Yeah.
From far away, at least.
Well, that's the nice thing about evolution. So, here's the map. Go ahead and skip past this. And we can take a look at that.
Now we can see where we're going.
Yep. Yeah.
So, we've seen that we've dealt with a good part of the dungeon so far. There's still a good deal left to go. Which way did I...
We're like slightly less than halfway.
Yeah. Or
maybe less than that even. Halfway through the main floors.
It's a tiny little thing above there.
A regular thing.
Now that we've got the map, I think we can head back to the twisted corridor. Alright, and here we are, right back at this twisted up corridor.
So twisty.
This is the best part of the temple, because take a look at this. And we've got an old friend here.
Oh no. Hello, Jan here. Nice to see you, nice. Lost.
You might remember these guys from Link to the Past. When they grab you, they take you out of the dungeon. Or in this case, send you back to the start of the dungeon.
Well,
So, unfortunately, we're missing a key. So, I got here a little bit too early, after all. But we got to meet the Wall Master. And I'm just going to look really quick. You can also see there's a weird chest there sitting on the wall.
Hmm. Interesting.
Yep.
And the ladder going the other way as well.
Yep. It's a nice layout. It's a well-made manor. So, Roxy, here's a question for you. Do you think that corridor was always there in this manor, or is that something that was added by something with Ganondorf's magic?
The twisty corridor?
Yeah.
I think it might have always been, to be honest, like that one corridor. Otherwise, if there were more of those corridors in the manor, I think we could have assumed that, like, okay, Ganondorf's magic kind of... it did this.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that one corridor was just put in there because whoever built the manor was like, you know what? Why don't we fuck with people?
The thing is, though, there's something going on there with gravity, obviously. So there's some kind of distortion going there.
But see, this is why I wish there was, like, in-game, like, explanation.
I was trying to think, does Furore have any association with, like, space or gravity or anything like that? Or is that all Nehru?
What?
I think that's all Nehru.
Oh.
I think, like, physical law stuff is all under her purview.
Is all under Nehru, yeah. Like, laws of gravity and shit.
Yeah.
Like, physics.
Because if it was a Furore associated thing, then you could chalk it up to that.
Mm-hmm.
So now we're into the absolute best part of any Zelda game, hunting for the key that you missed. Is it down here? This empty well? Oh, not an empty well. I thought it was an empty well. Maybe we'll empty it out later. Probably jumping ahead.
Yeah, there's a way to climb up, so assuming we can empty it out.
I'm gonna have to go back up these vines again, I think.
I love the balconies on this courtyard.
I think this might be the only place where you can actually pick up Deku sticks as Adult Link.
Hmm.
Because there's... because of that
normal
Deku
Baba. I mean, they drop them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you not, like, trim down the big Deku Baba?
I'm not sure. Let's try it. Oh, if I can actually hit it. Oh, you can. I never bother trying because they're so annoying to deal with. Well, that's interesting. Oh, and you can see over on that wall over there, gold sculpture, but we can't quite reach it.
Hmm. Yeah.
But we can reach this. There we go.
Okay. We did it.
Okay. Oh, I just realized what the intended thing actually was. So that let us actually drain the well that I was talking about before, that I forgot that you had to actually do. Now we can jump down in here. And actually get some progress. And this is a quicker way to get back and forth between the courtyards once you have it unlocked. I like how just the tiny chests, how young Link had to open up and all, but Adult Link just kicks them open.
Yeah. Like, Tiny Link had to, like, crawl into the chest, basically.
Yeah, yeah.
Even with the bigger ones, yeah.
It's cute. Okay. So, now that we've got that, again, back to the Twisted Corridor. So, here we are again. We actually have the key.
I wonder, if we shoot the eye, does that rotate this passageway? So that we come out of it, you know, at a different angle?
That would...
So we can access, like, the ladder and the chest?
That would make sense. These are very poorly done paintings. Well, unless it's modern art, but there's no plaque for context, so it's badly presented then. That one looks nicer and a little familiar. And if we approach it... Oh... Okay. Pocos.
I really love the Po sisters, actually.
Oh yeah, same.
Dude, go see the shadows.
See, I can flip too. Oh.
I like when they come up from underground because it, for a brief moment they look 2D.
Yeah. So I'm going to heal myself so that Roxy doesn't yell at me. But yeah, that is a cool effect.
I like that everybody sort of stands still while you take a drink.
Yeah. Oh, and by the way, notice that?
Did you block during the backflip?
Nope, this part. Oh, you might be a little bit behind. Yep, this is timed.
Oh boy. I've killed all the skeletons. More just keep going.
Nope, same one actually. Because if you take too long, they regenerate. So you split your attention between them, so that you can take them both down about the same time.
Hey. You did it. Ooh, is that a big chest?
It is.
What do we got?
Is it a... Usually when it's a big chest like that, it's an item?
Yep. Yeah. And it is this time.
We got a bow.
A tiny bow. Hey.
Oh.
It's actually a regular sized bow for a regular sized boy.
Yeah.
A fairy bow.
It just looks tiny right here.
Can't use a slingshot because it's too small, but this tiny bow? Nah, that's fine.
I guess it is a little small when you're actually building it. A little bit. All have the bow. So we're on the other side now. A little bit too close to that horn. But if we hit the painting while the ghost is inhabiting it, it vanishes. And if we leave the ghost with nowhere to go, it'll have to come out. Another little detail that I like is how each one of the Poe sisters has a slightly different design. It's not just four palette swaps. This one is Beth.
They just want to have fun.
Yep. So once you keep your what you want to do is just keep your distance here. It's a little bit of a slow mini boss once you figure it out, but only four hits. I thought it was dissolving. There we go. Okay. And finally, so now I will stop getting lost. Now let's head over to the other side again to handle the other Poe sister.